Hello friends, welcome to the video series lecture of Slit-lamp. This is the third part in which we will discuss about the diffuse illumination, and we will cover this video in two parts. In first part we will cover the setup, and second part the examination of ocular structures to be examined. So let's just start. Both observation and illumination arm are mounted coaxially. This is the observation arm and this is the scale, which shows the angle between observation and illumination arm. Now we have to turn the illumination arm to set the angle between both of them to 30 degrees. Then the magnification should be adjusted on 10 or 16x by rotating the magnification dial. Then after, switch on the slit lamp by this bottom button. The intensity of light, which can be regulated by this rheostat, should be moderate. Now it is adjusted to the moderate intensity. Now the slit lamp should be placed in vertical position by rotating this knob by using the angle, as you can see in this part. Now it is vertical. Now by rotating this knob, the height should be adjusted to the maximum level, that is 8 mm, which can be appreciated on this focusing rod. It slowly increases the length of the height. Then by rotating this knob, the width of the slit beam should be adjusted at its maximum level, that is 20 mm. As you can see, the width gets slowly increased by rotating the knob. Now the most important thing is to adjust the filter, which is used for diffuse illumination. It should be placed on the neutral density filter. So the final adjustment is this for the slit lamp setup. The first structure to be examined is eyebrows, which is examined for its color, density and presence of any scale or any deposits on the eyebrows. So which is very basic thing that we have to observe first during the ocular examination in diffuse illumination. The second structure is to be examined is the eyelid skin, which is examined for presence of lid crease or any abnormalities or any scales or deposits present on the eyelid skin. The third structure is to be examined is the upper eyelashes, which is examined for its color, direction and the presence of any extra rows of eyelashes. This is the normal appearance of eyelashes, that is, it looks normal in our subject. Now the same pattern is also observed in lower eyelashes for its color, direction and pattern, and presence of any extra rows, any misdirection of eyelashes that rub the cornea. The fourth structure to be examined is the lid margin, which is examined for the opening of Meibomian gland. As you can see in the video, the small circular white opening shows the Meibomian gland opening in the lid. Now it is more appreciable in the next structure is to be examined is the tarsal conjunctiva, which is examined for the presence of any papillae, follicles or any concretions that are present in the tarsal conjunctiva. As you can see, it is the clear tarsal conjunctiva, and the small circular structure shows the Meibomian gland opening on the upper eyelid. This is the normal pattern. The next structure is bulbar conjunctiva, in which the blood vessels are examined, which shows the presence of any chemosis or congestion is there in case of any abnormalities which are present in the bulbar conjunctiva, that can be easily appreciated. In this subject. This is the appearance of normal bulbar conjunctiva. As you can see in the video, these are the normal blood vessels and the normal shine of conjunctiva. If there is any dryness, the shine will go off. Next structure is cornea, which is examined for its transparency, and iris for its normal color pattern. Now the next structure is medial canthus, which is examined for lower punctum, which shows as a small pit. As you can see in the video, it is little magnified and better appreciable. In the same way, the upper punctum is also examined. It is little difficult to avoid the upper punctum, but it can be examined on the diffuse illumination. So in diffuse illumination, we get overview of anterior segment of eyeball. Now the last structure is to be examined is limbus, which is around 360 degree around the cornea, which is light grayish white in color, which is the transition zone between cornea and sclera. So stay tuned, please watch, like, subscribe, comment, and follow for next video very soon.